Hi, my name's Daniel, and let's understand you. You were born into this soupy body that may have that new car smell, but is haunted by genetic ghosts of behavioral tendencies, parents' drinking problems, and 70,000 years of the realization that, holy shit, I can do whatever I want, with all of the consequences. And they did anything they wanted, and the consequence is you. Presumably, you are doing okay. You do something for money, and that's good. Money's good, but you don't want to wait tables for 20 years. But when people ask, you say, I'm a waiter, which is unnerving. Somehow, you accidentally became someone. Oops. James Carse is someone who became the person who wrote this book, which uses game theory to explain why your life is a joke. And here's the premise. Life is made up of games. All games have rules, boundaries on a field, laws of the land, common decency. Sometimes you don't want to cross the line, sometimes you really do. But the nature of the line didn't change, merely our agreement on how to behave around it. A driver's license is given to those who agree to stay inside the lines, but there is no literal force keeping people from crossing the line. Humans are radically free to refuse to play by the rules, even if the cost is high. But we veil ourselves from this freedom and start believing that what we do, we must do, trapped in an agreement to play by the rules. And it's all because you forgot something. What did you forget? You forgot that the world is a stage. Stages are little scripted games of expectation. The script for how to act in a courtroom is different than that of a wedding. People act according to what the stage expects. To play the role of a lawyer, one must act like a lawyer, make decisions like a lawyer, to be licensed as one. There is a sense that one must maintain a certain level of performance and meet expectations, or the license to play may be taken away. The license does not belong to the licensed. The fear of being removed from playing a role you so strongly identify with makes life serious. There are things that could be lost, and won. When the point is to win, one begins to favor a desire for perfect knowledge and foresight. A master chess player seeking to always know the proper move to control the outcome. One who never loses, who is never surprised. There is a belief that if we are skilled enough, life can be won. The more skilled we are at playing our roles, the more likely we are to win. Roles become a means to an end, who we really are. Roles feel real in the same sense that an actor feels his performed emotions and actually says his memorized lines, but the very fact that they are performed means the lines belong to the role, not the actor. A woman who steps into the role of being a mother does so with the proper seriousness to act as the role requires, but the words of the mother belongs to the role, not to the person. If she defines her identity by her performance, then when the role is no longer needed, her persona will die and her identity will suffer a crisis. Performances are motivated by a specific conclusion. A mother mothers, an actor acts, a seducer seduces. Failing to achieve the goal of that role is the death of that identity. Think about how beauty is held onto even in old age, as an attempt to remain in a passing role that was really fun to play. And this is only natural. The ego is tasked with defining itself, to create and hold on to a convincing mask saying, I am a lawyer, I am a father, I am a creator. The great I am is our existential gasp into the universe, begging a cosmic, what? Who are you? I'm Daniel. But you're not seriously a series of letters and sounds. Okay, I'm a dyslexic writer, an editor. What if you did other things? So I'm a brother and son, a confused person. Really? Maybe I'm my memories and experiences. Would you still be you if you lost your memories? Were you you before having those experiences? You were you at 3, but there isn't a single cell remaining. But it was still you. Who are you? If you take away all the physical attributes of an apple, it ceases to be. But if you take away all the physical attributes of a human, there is something down there, an awareness seated within, the thing observing, that particular bit of consciousness stuck in your particular meat suit doing all of the naughty things that you are doing. Awareness has no identity. The witness to your life has no will, no agenda, and so it's bored. It wants to interact and be seen, but to be seen it must be clothed in something, and roles are the robes of the soul. It's funny that we all run around thinking that life is about getting somewhere, aiming our attention so often on what may be, fixated on some distant conclusion, believing there is some reward that will make everything worth it, but forget to be there for it. a dancer so consumed with getting to a particular part on the floor that they forget the point of dancing. The point of dancing is to dance, to feel your body move in rhythm, to shift your weight with someone else, to feel what it feels like to move fluidly with the music, to be with the sensations of a dancing being. Your life is a joke because it's meant for amusement. Life isn't about getting to the conclusion of the story as quickly as possible, but to act within the story, to engage in the sport of living. To be in on the joke is to play the game, fully aware of the dichotomy that the point isn't to win, but to play in such a way that the game continues. By all means, play your roles, and play them well, but remember that roles are the tools to express yourself and to interact with the world, not to be trapped inside of. Leave the lawyer in the courtroom, return home and place on the mask of parent or partner and play that role well. Be there. You are here to bear witness to your particular boundaries which create your individual field of play, and you, the player. The one who is here to mold, morph, choose, and otherwise canoodle with the rules of the game. Maybe we do it for some entertainment, maybe for some divine cause. Maybe we do it because we can. But it doesn't have to be so serious. It's not supposed to be. Embrace the abstractness of the roles. Take them on playfully. Let go of expectations. Replace them with intentions. Stop focusing on conclusions and open up to beginnings, hoping that fate will transform you, because it's going to do it anyways, and it's more fun when you don't take yourself too seriously. Be the soul moving fluidly from game to game with lightness and humor, growing out of old roles and into new ones, wearing a subtle smile behind the facade, delighting in the fact that you are alive, experiencing all of the things you are experiencing right now. Be present, be grateful, be playful. Do